alle mogelijke religieuze huizen gebouwd. Van christendom, islam, jodendom, hindoeïsme, etc. Dat gaat zo door. Ik vind, als je dus zo bekommerd bent om godsdienstvrijheid, dat er dan een prangender actieveld is waar je actief op kunt zijn. Kijk eens naar de onderdrukking van andersgelovigen in overwegend islamitische landen. Of het nou christenen of joden zijn. Als je met een kruisje om landt op het vliegveld van Jemen, dan word je aangehouden en krijg je een boete. Ik mag niet eens Mekka in als christen in Saoedi-Arabië. Laat staan dat ik een kerk zou mogen bouwen. Ik vind dat als je zo bekommerd bent met godsdienstvrijheid, neem het dan eens op voor die christenen en joden die bijvoorbeeld vervolgd worden in overwegend islamitische landen. Dus ik geloof niet dat onze grondrechten in deze constellatie gevaar lopen. En anders staat het CDA er zeker wel borg voor. Ik vind het van groot belang dat in het onderwijs wordt ontwikkeld wat ik heb genoemd de drie K's. De K van kunnen, dus capaciteiten. De K van kennen, dus kennis, know-how. En de derde K, de K van karakter. Dus of je ruggengraat hebt en integriteit. Die drie elementen zijn zeer belangrijk. En die zou ik ook willen terugvinden in alle sectoren van het maatschappelijk leven, voorop de politiek.
Op de Filipijnen was ik in 1999 in het kader van een gezondheidsproject. Ik heb daar ook mijn vrouw leren kennen, Anna Oleta. Die was directrice van de ABN AMRO Bank in Makati, Manila. Dat was een beetje het zakencentrum van Manila. En verder ben ik er vele malen geweest als hoogleraar internationale politiek op diverse universiteiten, maar met name ook op de Perpetual Help University in Las Piñas en Binyan en Moreno in de Filipijnen. Dus ik geef daar ieder jaar gedurende een bepaalde periode college. Ik ben net terug uit de Filipijnen, heb daar seminars gegeven voor de studenten over global threats. Dus mondiale dreigingen. En global threats en global trends.
Consul General, eh?
Yes.
Can I ask you a question? Have you heard of Mr. Olafur Buchelaar?
Oh, yes, yes. He's been an old friend. I met him during the incumbency of the former ambassador. That was last year, when I was quite new here in the Netherlands.
And what do you think of a Dutch professor going all the way to the Philippines to be with students there and help them about the politics?
I am amazed by his, first of all, by his interest of the country, and certainly of his knowledge, you know, of the country, the Philippines, and he's been very, very helpful. He's been doing lectures in the country, especially among students. A cabinet will be formed very soon, so that you will have a new government in place, and certainly we look forward to because in our case in the Philippines we also have a new president, yes, a new administration, so it would be a good fresh start for our relations.
I will do everything which is in my modest power to further the friendship and the relation and the cooperation between the Republic of the Philippines and the Kingdom of the Netherlands.
Yeah.
Well, I think that the Netherlands has a lot of experience in water management.
And luckily, the Philippines, sometimes, water is not only a blessing, but also a curse when there are tycoons. So maybe the Netherlands could offer to help the authorities in the Philippines in their combat against the water, against the tycoons. And besides that, I think that the government of the Philippines, especially also under this new democratically elected president, Benigno Aquino III, which is a very great statesman, that we have the obligation to help the Filipino democracy develop further. Let's not forget that the Philippines is a democratic country. It's also, if I may say so, the only country in Asia with a Christian minority. I don't have anything against Muslims, believe me, but I mean, the fact is that 93% or something of the Philippines is a Christian country. They have a civilizing mission in Asia, in ASEAN, and we should help the people, help the government of the Philippines.
Okay. Thank you very much again, Mr. Excellency, Consul General, for your hospitality and for answering a few questions. Thank you. Very grateful.
Yeah, in fact, I would like to confirm that indeed there's much that the Netherlands can do to help us. And there's much that we can learn from the Netherlands, especially in the area of water management, you know. Because, every year we are visited by as many as 20 storms, you know, these tropical storms called typhoons. And this causes a lot of destruction, floodings. And the Netherlands has a very good experience, you know, very wide experience in this field of flood control. So we need that technology, that expertise from your country, and also in terms of potable water supply, you know, because sometimes we have this, or not really sometimes, but oftentimes, especially now in the urban centers, during the dry season, we always have a shortage of potable water. So maybe also in that area we can learn from the Netherlands so much.
So Mr. Olaf Musai could do a lot being candidated again.
Certainly.
And then definitely that Philippines would be then on your agenda, Mr.
As Vice Chairman of the Committee for Foreign Relations of the CDE Zuid-Holland, I will further the cause of the Philippines. Also the aspects, as the Consul General has mentioned.
Okay. Thanks again for your cooperation.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Okay.
That's right.
Okay. 3 uur of zo. Maar dit is gratis.